Blessings, everyone. It's Tess Whitehurst. And today I want to talk to you about clutter clearing, one of my favorite topics. I have a new way to talk to you about it today. This is a motivational clutter clearing jumpstart. Another one, but it's a new way that I want to describe to you how clutter clearing helps clear the space for what you want to experience in your life. So, you know, if you've watched my videos before, you know I talk about magic and metaphysics and manifesting, and that one of the things I talk about a lot is feng shui and clutter clearing. It's boring, it's not as glamorous as things like affirmations or meditations or spells or rituals or crystals, but it's an amazing starting point for everything else. It creates space around everything else. It makes it so much easier to manifest what you want to draw into your life because it raises your vibration and it helps you get clear. But here are five specific ways that clutter clearing does this so you can get an idea of the dynamics, and then that will help motivate you to get started. So the first thing I want to talk about is books. Did I mention there are five? So the first one is books. You know, if you love books, everyone's different. There's no like, you know, cookie cutter for this is clutter and this isn't clutter. But if it nourishes you, if you love it, if it brings you joy, then that's a good, you know, indication it's not clutter. But with books, you want to, you know, it's like, I love books. Many people love books. But if I held on to every single novel I've ever read, I mean, most novels I'm not going to read more than once. And I would just have so many. And if that, again, if that brings you joy, that's one thing. But really think about it, because when you create space on your bookshelf, when you remove from your life, from your home, a book you're never going to open again, you create the space for fresh ideas. You create the space for new perspectives in the form of books. But because the outer world and the inner world are connected, this is a principle of magic, as above, so below, as within, so without. The book as a symbol, when you release books, then you symbolically create the space for fresh new ideas to flow in. So some of them I keep, and many, most of them I let go of. Okay, number two, pillows on your couch. So this is something that Ted and I don't completely agree on. He likes many, many pillows, and that's great. I mean, I don't mind. But one thing, you know, just to keep in mind, when you have company over, you want to make sure they have actual room to sit on the couch. When I was a feng shui consultant professionally, I would often see couches that had so many pillows on them that there wasn't really room to sit. You know, it's like you just kind of sit on the edge of the couch, and then the couch is just mostly for the pillows. And again, it's like you want to find the balance. If your partner, like me, you know, you and your partner aren't exactly the same on that, just find, you know, you can compromise on it. But do make sure that there's room for people's butts on your couch. That's a literal way of creating space for people to have, you know, enjoy, have a good time when you're entertaining, and to just feel comfortable, to feel welcome in your space. Number three is not exactly clutter clearing, but in a way it is, and it's covering your TV. You may have heard me talk about this before. If you have a TV, like a piece of furniture that, you know, closes over your TV, great. If not, you can cover it with a pretty cloth or a tapestry. And this is because this creates the space in the room for things other than TV watching. So, you know, when there's a black screen, you'll notice this now. We become so used to just seeing this like cold black screen when the TV's off. But when you start to tune into it, you realize it's not a good feeling. So it really encourages you to turn on the TV so you don't have to be in this kind of like, it just feels like, I don't know, like there's something that should be filled with light and movement and people and laughter and music, and it's just black and cold. It just doesn't feel good. But when you cover it up, oh, suddenly the room is available for conversation, for reading, for meditating, for playing with your cat, for all number of things. Number four is to remove stuff that's blocking the full range of motion of your doors, especially your front door. If there's anything behind your front door that is causing it to have limited range of motion, remove that. This is a symbolic creation of space for blessings and abundance to flow into your space. So if it's your, you know, doors within your space, then it's like symbolic of hassles, of feeling limited. You just want to feel, you know, this is a way to learn about how feng shui works. When you feel like it's easy to open all your doors, you feel like it's easy to open doors in life, like opportunities are open to you, things flow for you. So this is another symbolic but very real way to create the space for what you want to experience. Number five, clothes. So if you have anything in your closet that doesn't bring you joy to look at, then it's something that brings your confidence down a little bit just to have it in your closet. Like you look at it and you think, oh, that, you know what? I don't feel great in that. And then you're like, oh, like it just lends itself to you believing that's a way that you should feel about yourself, because you see it and then you remember it and then that energy's there. It's a psychological, subtle way that your confidence can become undermined. So when you clear everything out of your closet, except for the things that bring you joy to look at, that you like to wear, that feel good on your body, the colors are, you know, you feel great about the colors, that's a way to nourish your self-confidence. Okay, so those are five ways to clear clutter in order to create the space for what you want to experience. And I just want to mention, I would love for you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and the 2021 Your Most Magical Year Yet Planner is now available. So you can find that on Amazon. You can also find it in the shop at TessWhitehurst.com.